So now that you know more about your themes in terms of their characteristics, the next step that you have to think about is determining relationship among them. There are different kinds of relationship that you can look for. The first one is the causal relationship. So you ask yourself, based on what you know about the themes, does any of the theme cause the other theme? So is there any causal relationship? We are not doing statistics, right? Statistics where you find out whether it's a significant causal relationship between variables. Here, the causal relationship is, can this one inform the other, right? Does this theme affect the other theme, right? So that's how you have to look at it. So the second one is concurrent relationship. So are the themes happening at the same time, right? Do they occur at the same time? Chronological relationship. Does one theme comes before the other in a sequential manner? Explanatory relationship. Does one theme explains the other? Embedded relationship is, does a theme embed itself in the other theme, right? Does one theme, like one theme might be called dominant theme, and then the other theme comes under that dominant theme. Overlap, do they share something in common, right? So these are the things that you have to look into. So back to the example of the theme that we have. So you ask yourself, does having high workload have any relationship with being new to the profession, right? So maybe there might be a relationship. So this means that because participant maybe is new to the profession, they have a lot to learn and a lot to do, and they spend long hours learning and doing stuff, right? And they see their work as demanding, right? So it looks like there might be a chronological relationship between being new to the profession and having high workload. What about putting in extra effort, right? Because maybe you are new, right? It is causing you to put extra effort to learn and meet the expectation of patients, right? And that can also contribute to having less time with the family. So you see how being new can affect putting in extra effort to learn more, and can also happen at the same time of having high workload. And having high workload could affect or impact having less time for family. So these are how you're going to do it. You're going to explore which one comes first and which one, are they in a chronological relationship? Do they have a causal relationship? Do they have any embedded relationship? So you can, you know, explore and see whether it makes sense, and then you can come up with a proposed relationship between the themes that you have. Then when you come up with a proposed relationship, you have to see whether it reflects what is in the data, right? So that's what we're going to talk about in the next lesson. So thank you.